It was a cool, windy and wet day at times with a couple of millimetres of rain, occasional breaks of sunshine and moderate to fresh southwesterlies. Tonight, a gorgeous rainbow, the highlight of an otherwise dreary day that felt very wintry and out of season after days of warm sunshine. It only reached tops of 19 to 20 degrees across our western suburbs, including Penrith, Blacktown and Campbelltown, 17 in Terrey Hills and Cronulla and 19 in Gosford and the city, but it felt closer to around 12 degrees for most of the day thanks to the wind chill. The showers adding a little to the rain gauges, but more than halfway through the month, we've still only seen 13 millimetres of rain. That's compared to an average of 78. We saw a few light showers across the Illawarra and the south coast today. Everywhere else was mainly dry. It came after a chilly start. It was the coldest October night in 10 years for parts of the Riverina. Narrandera falling to just 1 degree, while Thredbo had the coldest minimum, dipping to -5 overnight. Today, coastal areas were cool and cloudy, only reaching 16 in Wollongong. Inland areas a little warmer under sunny skies, reaching a top of 21 in Mudgee, 24 in Dubbo. Tomorrow highs will maintain dry conditions across most of the country, while a trough over Queensland will cause a few afternoon showers and storms. Brisbane will be fine tomorrow, heading for 25 degrees, partly cloudy and 22 in Canberra, sunny and 23 in Melbourne and Hobart, with blue skies for Adelaide and Perth. The coast will be a little cloudy tomorrow, tops ranging from 19 in Wollongong up to a warmer 24 in Grafton. Inland areas will be mostly sunny, heading for 26 degrees in Griffith and Dubbo. Sydney will be cool and cloudy again tomorrow, but it should stay dry with light to moderate southeasterly winds, heading for tops of 21 to 22 degrees right across our western suburbs, including Blacktown and Campbelltown, 21 in Gosford in the city and 19 in Cronulla. Looking ahead, Thursday will be partly cloudy, 23 degrees, sunny and 25 on Friday, while the weekend is looking beautiful, blue skies and sunshine, heading for 26 degrees on Saturday, a warmer 30 degrees on Sunday. In our west, it will be partly cloudy and 26 on Thursday, warming up to a sunny 31 on Friday, 32 degrees on Saturday, 33 on Sunday. The warm and mostly sunny weather continuing into next week, Pete.
Hello again. On paper, the weather doesn't look much better than yesterday, just 16 degrees in the city, but it felt so much better under light breezes and dry skies. And Tullamarine made a considerable improvement. It had a feels-like temperature of zero at lunchtime yesterday, but at the same time today, it felt like 11. Inland parts of the state had a frosty morning. Horsham and Rutherglen both dipped below zero. Bendigo only just stayed above. Then this afternoon, areas north of the ranges warmed up to the high teens and low 20s, 16, 17 and 18 degrees through the south. A high-pressure system moved over Bass Strait today and that's delivered the calm and clear conditions. Tomorrow it will move over the Tasman, directing gentle northerly breezes our way and giving daytime temperatures a boost. Adelaide is expected to be our warmest southern capital, 26 degrees. Perth and Brisbane will be close behind, 25. And it doesn't happen often, but Sydney should be the coolest with a cloudy top of 21. Victoria is in for another chilly night. Ballarat is heading down to 1 degree. Widespread minimums of 2, 3 and 4, but only the central district is under a frost warning. Then under sunny skies and light northerly breezes, most spots are heading for the low 20s, a little warmer through the Wimmera and the Mallee. Melbourne is included in the frost warning, most likely through the nearby hills. There'll also be some fog about. Mount Dandenong is forecast to drop to 1 degree, Coldstream 2, Melton, Ringwood and Pakenham 3, 4, 5 and 6 elsewhere. But once the sun gets to work, we can expect maximums of mostly 23 or 24. For Geelong, a chilly low of 5 degrees, then a sunny top of 24. The city is forecast to dip to 6 ahead of a blue sky top of 23. Then a pair of 26 degree days and it'll stay quite mild overnight with minimums of 11 and 13. Cloud will increase Friday into Saturday, so that will keep it even warmer overnight. A low of 15, a top of 24. A big drop on Sunday, just 15 degrees with showers and it'll become windy. 16 on Monday, but it should bounce back next Tuesday, 22. But first, a chilly night. A low of 6 in the city, colder around the suburbs. Then under light northerly breezes, a sunny top of 23 degrees. Some lovely spring days ahead, Pete.
Thanks, Brenton. The marina pier at Glenelg looking very lovely on this quite sunshiny Tuesday. We've seen blue skies all across the board around Adelaide today. We came in just under 20 degrees in the city today, and right now it's around 18 degrees. The only thing was it was a bit of a cold start. It was around 6 degrees just before 7 o'clock this morning in the city, and around the suburbs we did see those cold starts as well, particularly in some of our northern suburbs. It was only 4 degrees at Mawson Lakes this morning and only 3 degrees up at Mount Lofty. Thankfully, those shivery starts, we ended up thawing out. We made up for it this afternoon with some spring sun and 23 degrees at Elizabeth. We saw clear skies across South Australia today as temperatures lifted into the mid-20s through the Flinders. Further south, once again, we did have some icy starts through the upper southeast. Narracourt was cold. Keith even colder, in particular dipping below zero. But it was 22 degrees there this afternoon. So what's bringing all of this sun? Well, basically the northeasterly winds are pushing all of that cloud cover out of the state, and that's why we have these blue skies with all of those clouds gone. Not everywhere is looking as sunny as Adelaide. Interstate tomorrow, Sydney is looking cloudy with 21. Canberra, a partly cloudy 22. Back home to SA, and temperatures are swinging up even further tomorrow. In fact, we're up to 32 degrees for Ceduna, 27 for Whyalla, and then Port Lincoln is expecting 26. And have a look at all of that sun stretching through our south. Nirriutpa expecting 26, and Murray Bridge warming even further to 29 degrees. On local waters, all looking very calm. Winds variable to around 10 knots and seas below 1 metre. I think you'll definitely notice it feeling warmer around Adelaide tomorrow, as those temperatures climb even further. We've got Elizabeth going for 28 degrees, Golden Grove 27, and Marion 26. Of course, we've got dry skies and plenty more sun in store with 26 degrees the top in the city. And it shouldn't be quite as cold overnight tonight. We're expecting to land at around 11 degrees overnight. After that, well, we just keep warming up. In fact, on Thursday, we're up to 30 degrees, which is certainly well above average for this time of year. And even on Friday, still very warm, rounding out the week with that dry top of 28 degrees. There is a cooler change coming through in time for the weekend. Sorry about the timing with that one, but we will see temperatures swinging back down to the high teens. There's a chance of a light splash or two on Saturday, but I wouldn't worry too much about that wet weather. And Sunday does look dry. And then after that, we sort of clear up pretty quickly for the beginning of next week.
Oh, Melissa, at least another 24 hours, especially the gusty southerlies along the coast. They'll start to ease a little bit for you Thursday. Much lighter winds by Friday and a return to some northerlies, and that means some much warmer temperatures. In fact, this coming weekend looking hot once again. Very little rainfall in the outlook over the next 7 days, but tomorrow, once again, we'll see some cooler daytime temperatures. Let's have a look at what we recorded across southeast Queensland today, courtesy of those strong southerlies. The coast only hit 24 degrees, and that was around all the bayside suburbs as well. 25 for Logan, Caboolture, 27 the city in Bow Desert, 28 in Gatton, 29 the high today recorded in Ipswich. With the weather map, high pressure continuing to bring fine and dry conditions across most of the country. Only the chance over Queensland with a couple of showers and storms with a trough. Interstate, we're looking at mostly sunny and warm conditions around Perth, Adelaide, Melbourne and Hobart. Cloudy in Sydney in 21, sunny in Darwin and 35 degrees. So Queensland for your Wednesday, mostly sunny for the north coast and tableland. Slight chance of a shower for the lower Burdekin and the central coast. Southeasterly winds and a little cloud for the Capricornia and Wide Bay. Sunny and hot inland. There is the chance of a late shower and storm for the central west. Here in the southeast, a partly cloudy day. The chance of a coastal shower only in those moderate southeasterly winds. Not a lot in it tomorrow. Cool overnight with minimum temperatures as low as 10 degrees inland, 15 bayside. With daytime temperatures, we're looking at low to mid-20s only. Moreton Bay, the south-southeasterlies, 15 to 25 knots, so not quite a strong wind warning. The seas up to 2.5 metres offshore. Brisbane, partly cloudy, fresh southeasters, overnight down to 16 and a high of 25 degrees. 7-day outlook, partly cloudy Thursday, 26, fine Friday and 28, Saturday 29, Sunday 30 and Monday 32 degrees. In Ipswich, fine and warming up from Thursday. We're looking at low 30s for Friday and over the weekend by Monday, 35 degrees. For the Gold Coast, cloudy Thursday, 24, fine Friday and 26. A mostly sunny weekend. We should see high 20s over the weekend and by Monday topping out at 29 degrees. degrees, so a magic one on the coast. The same really for the Sunshine Coast, just a little bit of cloud Thursday and 24, fine Friday and 26, mostly sunny weekend, high 20s each day, back to blue skies by Monday and topping out at around 30 degrees. So a little bit of cloud tomorrow, still the fresh southeasterlies. If there is a shower, it'll just be along the coastal fringe, but it'll be less than a millimetre at most. And then clearing up, warming up, guys, just in time for the weekend, the most important 2 days of the week.
Yeah, that's